The entire point of the drop shot is to allow us to be able to transition into the kitchen with ease. So the better the drop shot, the easier the transition. Today in specific, I'm going to be sharing with you the top 5 places to hit your drop to make your opponents pop up the ball and as a result, make your transition as easy as possible. Okay, starting with optimal spot number 5, it's going to be placing your drop behind the opponent that is already established up at the non-volley zone line. So my partner just returned the ball, they're transitioning forward. Now it's my job to cover whatever ball is coming. So if I think that my opponents are gonna drive the ball or drop the ball, I'm automatically gonna hover over the middle and try and take this next shot out of the air to alleviate some of the stress from my partner that's transitioning up to the net. So keeping all that in mind, I, as the dropper over there, wanna drop it behind this player. This can be a great spot to put the ball, but it's also a high risk, high reward spot. Because if you drop this shot here and I fail to cover the middle and try to alleviate some of that stress from my partner, which I shouldn't anyway, but at the same time, you'll get players that won't. Now you have just provided me with a perfect Ernie opportunity where I can jump over the kitchen and hit this ball out of the air. And now I can hit a massive angle over here, or I can just pretty much hit an overhead from that Ernie. So it's your job as the dropper to pay attention to the player that's already established up at the net and see where they're covering. Because if they're covering for their partner, then it's gonna be a great spot to hit behind them. And something to pay attention to is if it is their backhand that they're having to cover or if it's their forehand and their lefty, or you're on the right side of the court and it's their forehand. I would suggest exclusively doing this to people where their backhand is on the outside of the court so that you're hitting it not only behind them, but also to their weaker side. This will typically cause a pop-up and put you guys automatically from defense to offense. 0-0-1. This video is sponsored by Hesicor. This is the undergrip that I use on all of my pickleball paddles. It has a hexagon-like shape that fits perfectly into your palm and all of your knuckles, which makes it extremely easy for you to be able to find your grip and also makes it so that your grip stays where it should as you're playing pickleball. So if you would like to try one of these out, the link is right here. You get 10% off through my link. You can go ahead and click there and pick yourself up a Hesicor grip. Okay, optimal spot number 4 is going to be hitting to the weaker player. So placing your drop at the weaker player. Now this one's obvious. Obviously the weaker player is not gonna have as easy of a time returning a drop as the better player would. So putting it in a tournament to the weaker player will cause more mistakes from your opponents. It'll put more pressure on them. Now, where my opinion changes is when we're playing in rec play. When you're playing in rec play, you actually wanna hit your drops to the better player because rec play is an opportunity to improve and become better so that you can perform better in tournaments. So the reason that you wanna hit it to the better player is because they're gonna be able to place that shot a little bit better, and it's gonna cause you to reflect and hit your next drop even better, or to go for a little bit smaller margins. And it's gonna turn you into an overall better dropper. Optimal spot number 3 to hit your drop is up the middle. And I know that this might surprise a lot of people, and a lot of people might think, well, aren't there just huge forehands in the middle and people smacking away at overheads? Isn't that a high risk spot? And the reason that it's not a high risk spot is because in the middle, my ability to pull you out into the fence or hit a huge angle is very small. The higher up you lob the ball, so the less of a drop that it becomes, the bigger my angle becomes. So the higher up, I get a little bit bigger of an angle. But then as I go out wide, if you were to hit that same exact drop out wide, my angles are now this big. So you can see how much bigger I can come hard down the line, or I can practically hit it into the kitchen over here with an overhead on my backhand or my forehand side. If it's not an overhead and I'm just hitting, you know, you hit a decent drop, I can jump the kitchen. And then I can still hit that massive angle. It's actually a bigger angle the further out that I stand. So if instead you hit your drop here, my angles become this. Higher up it goes, they get a little bit wider, but it's not anything that the opponents at the baseline won't be able to handle. So if you hit your drop here, you're gonna really consistently come up to the net, probably more consistently than any other drop, because I'm not gonna be able to do much with the ball. So if you hit your first drop here, and let's say it's a little high, I hit an overhead, you hit your next drop here and it comes in a little bit lower, there's no angle that I can possibly hit. I'm just gonna have to hit the ball back to you or drop shot, which is kind of what you want anyway, because that's gonna allow you to be able to transition into the net even quicker. So if you can keep your drops low and up the middle, you're just gonna transition to the net time and time again. Thank you. The second most optimal spot to hit your drops is going to be at the returner. Typically, when the returner returns the ball and they're running forward, they don't quite make it to the non-volley zone line before your ball makes it to them. So if you can drop that ball at their feet, they're gonna be a ways off of the non-volley zone line. Typically 2 to 3 feet off the non-volley zone line, they're hitting that shot at their feet. And it's not just that, but they've also got all of their momentum behind them. So they're running, 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 running. You hit it at their feet, and now it's causing them to stop in their tracks. They're now off balance, and it automatically puts them in a defensive position. Straight from an offensive return, they run forward, and now they're in a defensive position, leaning back, having to change their momentum from going forward to backward, and they're just trying to keep that ball in play. And all that they're thinking about is, I can't pop this up, because if I pop it up, they're just gonna put that next ball away, which is referred to as the drop and take, which I went over in one of my previous videos. I'll be sure to link that right here if you'd like to learn some of pickleball's best plays. So even if your drop isn't perfect and you can get it to the returner, it's gonna be a whole lot better than getting it to the returner's partner, because the returner's partner is already in an offensive position. They're one up on you because they're up at the net, you're back. They have way greater angles, they're leaning forward, they're on balance. They can slam that next ball. So it's a little bit scarier to go to them. Whereas the player that hasn't made it to the non-volley zone line yet is in a defensive position, and it kind of neutralizes the point. Typically you're gonna get a pop-up. Okay, we have arrived at the number one most optimal spot to place your drops, and that is at the inside leg of your opponent that just returned the ball. The reason that I say inside leg is that's gonna be the leg that the backhand is on, regardless of righty or lefty. This works best when the righty is returning from the right side of the court or the lefty is returning from the left side of the court. Because as a lefty, if I return from the left side of the court and I'm running forward, you hit to my inside leg, I'm gonna be hitting a backhand here. Whereas if I'm a lefty and I return from the right side of the court and you hit to my inside leg, that's gonna be my forehand side. This will typically happen when you are serving from right side, because there's way more righties than there are lefties. So those two circumstances are optimal depending on if you're playing a righty or a lefty to use this drop, and you'll see just a ton of success with it simply because this is such an awkward position, because you have to move your inside leg out of the way in order to hit this backhand since it's coming at the feet. And a lot of people will reach in and try to get that ball out of the air, and almost every time that's going to be a pop-up.
The app Pickleball Drills is now available on the App Store and on Google Play. It has hundreds of drills to choose from, including dinks, drives, drops, volleys, and much, much more. So simply click the paddle icon to the left of your screen, download the app, and start drilling now.